Our headline for today is Emergency Response Plan. Let's go further detail regarding this topic. What is Emergency Response Plan? Emergency Response Plan is an action developed to mitigate the damage of potential events that could endanger an organization's ability to function. Such plan and proper employee training will result in fewer injuries and less structural damage to the facilities during the emergencies. Let's look at some examples of accidents in the workplace.
Emergency response plan addresses the predictable and prepare for the unpredictable incident. It is designed to prevent loss of human life and minimize damage to project premises and the environment.
What are the key components of effective emergency response plan?
The first key component of emergency response plan is the assessment of potential hazard and threats. Secondly is the development of appropriate response plan. Next is the formation of properly trained and well-equipped response team. The ultimate effectiveness of any emergency response plan lies in the ability of a trained and coordinated emergency response team to implement a response operation in a timely and effective manner. These are the organizations that are responsible for implementation of environmental response plan.
There are five priorities of emergency response plan. Number 1, protection of human life and the environment. Number 2, prevention for minimization of injury. Number 3, reduce asset and environmental exposure. Number 4, optimize loss control. And lastly, restore normal operations quickly.
Malaysian government has recognized the need to regulate activities with potential to cause major hazards, which leads to implementation of several legislations. Firstly, Occupational Safety and Health, Control of Industrial Major Accident Hazards, Regulations 1996. Under this regulation, it stated the need for certain industries to create their own emergency response programs. Secondly, the National Security Council Directive No. 20, MKN20. This is the national policy on disaster, industrial accidents such as explosions, fire, pollution and leaks of hazardous material from plants are incidents covered under this directive. Thirdly, the Fire Services Act 1988. It stated the need for premises to obtain a fire certificate. Next, the Uniform Building Bylaws, 1984. It stated the need for fire alarms, fire detection, fire extinguishment and firefighting access.
Level of emergencies. An emergency situation at the project site can be defined as an occurrence involving major fire or an urgent rescue requirement, which has potential to endanger the safety of the following prospects: the proposed project, its workers or the general public and the environment, or situation that could lead to damage to company property or those neighboring plants.
Level 1 emergency is categorized as a situation which does not unduly concern human lives or assets. This emergency can be handled by plant personnel. For example, a member of plant personnel that had personal injuries due to plant operation, or fires that can be contained and put out by the workers at the proposed plant. A level 2 emergency is categorized as a situation which significantly concerns human lives and assets and might lead to a more serious incident. It involved the participation of neighboring plants and other external public agencies. The incidents happened in this level may affect the entire project, and may also affect the surrounding community. For example, fault electrical wiring with consequent fires in the proposed project which cannot be contained in-house. Or, accident during transport of scheduled waste with resultant spillage on public roads. Level 3 emergency involves a major accident and is a serious threat to human life and assets. It is also involving the participation of all neighboring plants and relevant authorities. Example of an incident is the fires that cannot be contained and may spread to other neighboring plants.
How to declare an emergency? Declared is made as soon as any of the emergency situations are reported in the following manner. Inform the plant manager if the emergency is a level 1 emergency. Activate the emergency siren continuously for at least 2 minutes for level 2 and level 3 emergency. If the emergency is in-house and informing fire department, police, DOE, etc.
Important elements for emergency response plans.
There are seven important elements of emergency response plan. The first element that need to be considered in emergency response plan is a vulnerability assessments. Vulnerability assessment is important to find which hazards pose a threat to any specific site or company. During this assessment, there are several sources of information are needed, such as records of past incidents, occupational experience, and knowledge of both technological and natural hazards by consulting with external organizations such as fire departments, consultants, and government department. Second element that need to be considered for emergency response plan is a chain of command. The employer should designate an emergency response coordinator and also the backup coordinator. Every employee should know who is the appointed designated coordinator in case of reporting an emergency. Duties of the coordinator and employer include: determine what emergencies that may occur and planning emergency procedures to address each situation. Directing all emergency activities including evacuation of personnel. Ensuring that outside emergency services are notified when necessary. And also directing the shutdown of plant operations when necessary. Next is creating emergency response team. These teams are the first lines of defense in emergencies. Members of emergency response teams should be thoroughly trained for potential crises and physically capable of carrying out their duties. One or more teams must be trained to use various types of fire extinguishers, to do first aid, including cardiopulmonary resuscitation, to understand bloodborne pathogens risk, to conduct shutdown procedures, to handle chemical spill control procedures, to search and conduct emergency rescue procedures as well as hazardous materials emergency response. Alarms and communication systems are also important to be considered in emergency response plan. In a situation requiring evacuation, the first step is to let all occupants know they must leave the building. Alarms must be both seen and heard to notify individuals, including the disabilities persons. Next is suppression systems. Suppression systems are designed to put out fires. There are many types of suppression systems, and not all are suited for every situation. Inspection and tests should be done on the system to ensure they will work when needed. Next, the element that is also need to be considered in emergency response plan is the evacuation planning. The goal of this planning is to evacuate people and move resources, equipment, supplies, inventory, out of threatened areas. The designation of refuge or safe areas for evacuation should be determined and identified in the plan. The planning should also establish methods to warn the employees and customers. Maps indicating evacuation routes from buildings and facility sites should be included in the plan. There are several criteria that need to be met for the escape routes, which are: there should have enough exits, exits should not be blocked, exits should be clearly marked, the route should be wide enough, exits should lead to a public thoroughfare, escape routes do not lead through any area that may cause more danger to the evacuees, and secondary routes should be available in case primary route is blocked. Last element is rescue and emergency medical facility. The employer should find out which medical facilities are closest to them. This may help to coordinate an emergency action plan with the outsider responders such as the fire department, hospital emergency room, and EMS providers. In certain cases, it may be necessary to have emergency medical and rescue services on site.
Now let's see the example of emergency response plan for a dam project.
There are two main functions of emergency response plan for this project, which are primary function and secondary function. Both functions are important to provide a means of notifying downstream residents of failure or impending failure of a dam, so that the area can be evacuated in a timely manner. However, for secondary function, planning should also include delay strategies of the failure until after downstream residents have been alerted.
Before creating the emergency response plan, several questions should be answered in case of dam project failure. For example, downstream flood path, district, number of villages and number of people that will be affected. Here is the example of notification procedures of emergency response plan for a dam project.
Rescue plan need to be prepared beforehand and should include the following. When there is an incident of dam failure, police and military helicopters should fly over to the flood path and check on signs of people that trapped in vehicles, buildings or high ground. As water will be starting to subside, the following rule of priority for rescue should be followed. Starting from the people in water, people in vehicles, people in or on buildings, and lastly people on high ground. fire brigade, Red Crescent, police, army, and all those who know first aid must enter the area quickly to administer aid to survivors. Survivors might be trapped in mud, collapsed buildings, or among debris. Therefore, heavy equipment might be needed to rescue survivors. However, the path of the equipment must be checked to prevent accidental trampling or run over of survivors. All available excavation machinery must be put on standby and sent to the required areas. It may be necessary to get the assistance from the private contractors. Boats can be used to rescue people. However, it may not be very effective as the river will be full of debris from collapsed buildings and trees. Flood relief plan. This plan is important to alleviate the suffering of the flood victims. Several steps that need to be taken under this plan are as following. Firstly, provide immediate shelters to accommodate all victims. If necessary, open new shelters to relieve overcrowding at the immediate shelters. Secondly, provide food to the victims. Next, build or find temporary homes as fast as possible. The health department must enter the inundated areas and check for any outbreak diseases or possible danger to health. Lastly, start rebuilding the homes once the health department confirms that the area is safe to enter. People should be allowed to return when their homes are ready.
That's all for this topic. Hope you enjoy the video. Thank you for watching.